Good morning to all the students of class plus 2C. Beta, as you know, we have proposed chapter Rat Trap. We already started, but because it was not in the first term, so then I left this chapter in between. We have read 3 pages earlier, but again, because the link is broken, so we would be starting it again. Okay. Before starting, Beta, you can see the board clearly. Is it visible to you? If you can see the reflection of light, is it? I would be explaining. Firstly, I have introduced the characters, fine? Very first, I have written the characters on the basis of priority, the way they enter into the chapter, fine? The way they enter into the story, on that sequence-wise, I have just written. Firstly, we have the peddler, fine? Peddler is the protagonist of the chapter. Peddler is the person who walks on foot to, you can say, sell off his things. So he is the one who is making and selling the rat traps. Rat traps, you know, the rat traps, your mothers, they just keep it in the, especially in the kitchens, so that all the rats are caught inside it. They put a bait, they hang some pork, cheese, bread or roti, you can say, anything they keep inside. The moment the rat touches the bait, it shuts and rat is caught. That's why the name of the chapter is the rat trap. But actually, this rat trap is used here in metaphorical manner, in deeper way. It is like the world is rat trap to us, and we all people are just like rats. And we are getting attracted towards worldly things, material things, and one day each one of us will be caught. So this is the idea behind this chapter, Rat Trap. Yeah. So second character is the crofter. The person who he would be meeting, this peddler would be meeting in between the chapter, and when he would be going alone and he wanted a night shelter to stay there, and he knocked at one of the huts, and crofter would be, you know, welcoming him because he was also living all alone. So they shared a meal, tobacco, and they would be playing cards together, majolis together, fine. Then third character is Iron Master, who's having that iron mill amidst the forest, and where this peddler would be reaching, fine. And Iron Master would be, you know, recognizing him as one of the old acquaintance. We have read till acquaintance, fine. But we would be explaining, I would be explaining everything to you again. Then fourth character is Adela, who is the daughter of Iron Master. Clear? Adela is the daughter of Iron Master. So all the characters are clear to everyone. Then I have written the theme. In the theme, Beta, theme is developed with the help of the metaphor of the rat trap. I already told you the whole world is a rat trap, and also they will be developing the theme on the basis of this metaphor. Now, two themes are basically part of this chapter, essential goodness in everyone. So it says this chapter will be unfolding that everybody is good enough, you know, nobody is bad. Inherent goodness lies in everyone. The need is to extract it out, you know. Everybody is good enough, just we need to see that goodness in someone and we need to help them out. Everybody is fighting their own battle, you know. We just need to polish them, we need to talk to them, communicate with them, we should show love and affection to them, fine. And essential goodness lies in everyone, and it can be awakened through love and understanding only. You can, you know, this can be awakened with this thing only. Clear? Now I would be sharing the screen, Beta. You can see chapter. So quickly we will be doing, because we have read so far from Once Upon a Time onwards. Okay. Once upon a time, there was a man who went around selling small rat traps of wire. He made them himself at odd moments from the material he got by begging in the stores or at the big farms. So you can see this man, who's a peddler, While class 10th is trying to enter. Okay. Still some students are having confusion about the timetable. You should check it properly, beta. So this man peddler who went around selling small rat traps, and how he would collect those rat traps, actually he would beg sometimes to people to collect money. Sometimes he would do petty thievery. He was not a professional thief, I must tell you. He used to do the petty thievery, small act of thievery, you can say. And then he would buy material for his rat trap buyers and all. He would collect that and then he would make rat traps. He would dangle those rat traps around his neck and then he would move here and there to sell them off. So that was the way he was surviving anyhow. Clear? Srishti beta, kindly join Valentine. Srishti, you are already late, beta. Please well join well in time always. So business was not profitable, but he was just, you know, having hand to mouth existence. So he had to resort to both begging and petty thievery to keep body and soul together, means to survive. Even so, his clothes were in rags, his cheeks were sunken and hunger gleamed in his eyes. Though he was earning, but even then you can see that hungry face, the hunger in the gleam, hunger was gleaming in his eyes, and you know, sunken is submerged, and it is quite visible that how kind of a physical situation he was having, that somebody is hungry. We can easily perceive that. No one can imagine how sad and monotonous life can appear to such a vagabond. Vagabond is but a wanderer. Vagabond is a wanderer, the person who keeps on moving from one place to another, the ones who do not have a place to, proper place to live in, a permanent place, who plods along the road left to his own meditations. On meditations means on thought process. So he keeps on having his own ideas, thinking, thoughts, and he keeps on moving from one place to another. He had naturally been thinking of his rat traps, when suddenly he was struck by the idea that the whole world about him, the whole world with its lands and seas and cities and villages, was nothing but a big rat trap. So one day when he was moving here and there, he had this idea. This idea clicked his mind that, okay, the whole world is just like rat trap. The way I'm selling rat traps, one day all the rats will be caught into my rat traps. Similarly, we all people are also like rats. Clear? The whole world with its lands and seas, its cities and villages, was nothing but a big rat trap. It had never existed for any other purpose than to set baits for people. It offered riches and joys, shelter and food, heat and clothing, exactly as the rat trap offered cheese and pork. And as soon as anyone let himself be tempted to touch the bait, it closed in on him and then everything came to an end. So this is the idea, you can underline. One day this peddler had this idea. The way rat enters the rat trap by seeing the cheese and pork, and the moment it touches the bait, it shuts and the rat is caught. Similarly, we all people will be getting attracted towards materialistic things. Some people want good clothing, shelter, food, cars, whatever. All are attracted towards material benefits, and when we touch them, it shuts upon us and we people are just engrossed in it and we are lost. Mind, we are enclosed behind the bars of these worldly rat trap. Clear? The world had, of course, never been very kind to him. So it gave him unwanted joy to think ill of it in this way. It became a cherished pastime of his during many dreary ploddings to think of people he knew who had let themselves be caught in the dangerous snare, and of others who were still circling around the beach. This paragraph simply means, according to the peddler, there are two kinds of people living in this world. Two kinds of people. First category of the people who are already caught in the bait, in the rat trap. Second category of people who are about to touch the bait and definitely will be caught up. So according to peddler, every one of us will be caught one or the other day. This is the meaning of this paragraph. And during his dreary means dull, plodding means walking and trudging the paths. So during his dull routine, dull walking, on everyday basis, he used to have this idea. So this was the routine of this peddler to think about this idea, this philosophical idea, I must say. So now, entry of Beta Crofter, one dark evening. Now, one dark evening, as he was trudging, he was walking along the road, he caught sight of a little grey cottage by the roadside. And he knocked on the door to ask shelter for the night. Nor was he refused. Instead of the sore faces which ordinarily met him, the owner, who was an old man without wife or child, was happy to get someone to talk to in his loneliness. Now, Beta, let me tell you one more theme of this chapter. You know, loneliness. Loneliness can be dangerous for us also. You know, these days you have seen many people are getting secluded due to COVID. They are just home quarantine and all. So when we are secluded, we start having negative thoughts. We always need someone to talk to. We always need a friend who is sharing our idea. We always want our parents by our side who are listening to us, at least if they are not even reacting. We want anyone to listen to us quietly so that we just feel relaxed. So this is one of the themes that loneliness, can lead to make more friends also. So he is a lonely man, this peddler, as well as this crofter in whose house he's going to reside. Fine. So, you know, peddler does not have any home to live in. Once he reaches a place and he wanted to stay for a night, he knocked, he used to knock at various doors, and obviously nobody will allow any stranger to enter their house. But one day when he just knocked at the door of this crofter, he was surprised that this crofter allowed him to enter his house. Fine. Why he allowed? Because he also was alone. He was not having any family. He wanted someone to talk to. He thought, okay, this is a good idea. I should give shelter to this stranger and we would have a good time together. But any doubt so far? Because I have just increased the speed because we have done already this chapter, this three pages. Send me thumbs up, Beta, if it is clear to you. If you have any doubt, you can ask me. Okay, Karthik is saying okay. What about others? Now, so in his loneliness, he wanted someone to talk to. He was happy. So immediately he put the porridge pot on the fire and gave him supper. Supper means dinner. Then he carved off such a big slice from his tobacco roll, and it was enough both for the stranger's pipe and his own. Finally, he got out an old pack of cards and played majolis with his guest until bedtime. The old man was just as generous with his confidences as with his porridge and tobacco. The guest was informed at once that in his days of prosperity, his host had been a crofter at Ramso Ironworks and had worked on the land. Now that he was no longer able to do day labor, it was his cow which supported him. Yes, that bossy was extraordinary. She could give milk for the creamery every day. And last month, he had received all of 30 kroner in payment. Now, this crofter, he was so generous. He shared his porridge, a big slice of tobacco roll he shared with him. They played game of majolis. This is a card game. And they spent good time together. And because both were very lonely. So old man became quite friendly. This old crofter became quite friendly with this peddler. And he started telling him that, you know, recently, I have earned 30 kronos. Kronos is the currency, Beta. So he says that I have just recently earned 30 kronos. He showed him three notes of 10 kronos each. And, you know, after milking the cow, I could just gather this much amount. And he was so happy to share this news with this stranger. Stranger must have seemed incredulous. Incredulous here means unwilling to accept. And crudeless here means unwilling to accept. So for the old man got up, sometimes, you know, we give such expressions that, okay, we don't believe you in that way without saying. So, you know, that peddler gave such kind of expression. So the old crofter thought, okay, he does not believe that I have 30 kronors. So what he did, he just got up, he went to the window, took a leather pouch, which was hanging around the window frame, and he took out 30 kronors, those wrinkled notes, and he just showed to his guest, see, I have 30 kronors. And after showing it to the guest, again, he put those notes back and hung around the same window. Clear? The next day, both men got up in good season. Good season means in good mood. The crofter was in a hurry to milk his cow. And the other man probably thought he should not stay in bed when the head of the house had gotten up. So what is going to happen here? Next day, both of the men, crofter as well as peddler, they both got up, and that old man was in a hurry because he was working. He has a routine. And he just wanted to go for milking his cow. He thought, okay, I'm going. And obviously, if the owner of the house is leaving, then the person who has taken shelter will not stay there. So this man, peddler, also decides, ki, okay, I should also get up and go. So crofter locked the door and put the key in his pocket. Both of them bid goodbye to each other and they followed their own paths. But half an hour later, you know, rat trap peddler stood again before the door. So this is something fishy. Half an hour later, this peddler came back. Who's the peddler? This vagabond, the protagonist. You know, you remember he would do petty thieveries. And he would, you know, beg also sometime. But in this case, he's going to steal the amount of this crofter. So he was standing again. Half an hour later, he came back, smashed a pane and stuck in his hand and got hold of the pouch with 30 kronor, took the money and put the money into his pocket and again just hung the leather pouch very carefully back at its position. As he walked along with the money in his pocket, he felt quite pleased with his smartness. He's thinking, wow, what a smart guy I am. I have very smartly broke that window pane and I have extracted the money out of it. So I should go. He realized, of course, that the first he dare not continue on the public highway. He must turn off the road into the woods. During the first hours, this caused him no difficulty. Later in the day, it became worse, for it was a big and confusing forest. So now I'd be just explaining the gist of this bit up. He is thinking that he's very smart after stealing the amount of the crofter. Right? Crofter has gone to milk the cows. And he thought, okay, peddler has also gone. But peddler went back and stole that amount of 30 kronors. And now he thought, if I would be choosing the public highway, I can be caught easily. So rather than I should choose the way from the forest. Fine. And he chooses the forest from the very first few hours where he was able to spend quite easily. He was moving and walking because he was not having any food along with him. And he was so tired. Again, he was lost into his thoughts, you know, and he was thinking that now I myself, you know, I'm caught into the bait. This is the time where he's thinking that his own turn had come. Okay, underline this. When did he realize this? The whole forest with its trunks and branches, its thickets and fallen logs closed in upon him like an impenetrable prison from which he could never escape. So why impenetrable, which cannot be reached? He was going somewhere and reaching that the same place again and again. He was lost into the forest. He walked so many miles. He was dead tired. He wanted to sleep. He wanted to eat food. Fine. But that was the problem. He was not able to find his path. It was late in December. I guess we would be able to read again. I just want ki we have already covered till iron mill, or maybe let's start. We'll be able to finish it off or not. We are left with few minutes only. It was late in December. Darkness was already descending over the forest. This increased the danger and increased also his gloom and despair. So December month is going on, quite wintry night, and he was feeling quite hungry, and he was having that gloomy and sad, you know, mood. Finally, he saw no way out and he sank down on the ground, tired to death, thinking that his last moment had come. But just as he laid his head on the ground, he heard a sound, a hard, regular thumping. You know, when we keep our heads down on the ground, we can feel that echo. When he just put his head on the ground, he was dead tired. He was not able to walk anymore. He could hear the sound of hard thumping, that as if somebody is thumping with the axe or some other equipment. There was no doubt as to what that was. He raised himself. Those are the hammer strokes from an iron mill. So it was quite audible to him that these are definitely the hammer strokes. Somebody is using hammer, and that's why he's able to hear those chime sound again and again. And there must be people nearby. So he thought that definitely I'm quite near to some people. He summoned, he gathered his strength, got up and staggered in the direction of the sound. So now he would be reaching this Beta Ramso Ironworks, which are now closed down, but not long so ago, large plant with smelter, rolling mill and forge in the summertime, long lines of heavily loaded barges. We have read so far till he has entered here. Okay. So now, before reading, we would be just discussing what's there in the story. Any doubt to anyone, Beta? I'm again asking. Send me thumbs up who are listening to me. I just want to check up till last who is there. Lakshit. Let me just go into the gallery view and see. I would be announcing the names, those who are sitting: Anushka, Anmol, Rana, Vaibhav, Suhani, Harnoor Singh, Kartik, Fateh, Chandan, Vaibhav, Saransh, Vanshika, Kakshi. Those who have not raised their hands, it means something fishy. You know, you do not switch on the cameras. I need to check. This Gaurav is there, okay. What about Fateh Singh? What about Tegveer Singh? Fateh, you are listening? Okay. Tegveer, raise your hand.
Ma'am, I did.
Okay, fine. Then raise your hand, because I'm just seeing, because you do not switch on the cameras. I want to check whether you people are paying attention or not. Kartik, are you there? Dipen, send me thumbs up. Yes. Are you there? Kartik is there. Okay, fine. So, because we're not having much time today, and tomorrow, Beta, please see the timetable and join accordingly. I need not send personal messages to join the period and all. You should join well in time. And we have covered whatever we have read previously. Okay. So from page 35 onwards, we would be starting tomorrow onwards. I increased the pace because we have already done this much earlier. Okay. Don't think that why ma'am is rushing with this. We have already completed this much. So that's why I was just running with that. Speed was fast, you can say. Any doubt to anyone, you can ask me.